What's an addiction that no one takes seriously enough? Phone addiction. So I just went 2 weeks with my phone in the shop with a shattered screen, and honestly, it was fucking bliss. I looked into getting a landline recently and was pretty horrified to discover how difficult it is to do, and how rare the service even is these days. Like, I hate this freaking thing. Self-deprecation. It starts as just jokes to break the ice in social situations. Then it becomes a form of sarcasm ingrained into your everyday speech. Then it becomes a true depiction of how you see yourself, and it spirals into depression. Attention. And it can manifest in so many ways, like social media, causing issues in school, causing chaos, etc. Energy drinks. And people get in the habit of like, man, I don't know why I'm so low on energy today, I think I need another Red Bull. But no, you need freaking water. Skin picking. My index, thumb, and middle fingers are permanently destroyed, and all my parents say is, you've got to stop. Yeah, no, I can't. Sorry, mom and dad. Work. So many of my friends in their late 20s work themselves to exhaustion, go out for drinks, and talk about work for 3 hours. Get called in early to work the next day, and kiss the boss's ass on their days off. On the same merit, I'm finally disgusted by how effective it is to brown-nose managers. Like, you can't fire the guy who the entire company has issues with because he treats you like you're his favorite person? Food. Also the hardest to break, as you can't go cold turkey or abstain. Social media addiction. And I think eventually we will find out that social media contributes to mental illness someday, and children are already ruining their lives with it every single day. Chapstick. My lips will never let me give up chapstick until I die. If I start using it because my lips are dry, it just seems to make my lips even more dry for some reason, yet I cannot stop using it for the life of me. Nasal spray. So I used Afrin for about a week straight, maybe longer, while I had a really bad cold and was tired of it. I proceeded to experience the most insanely painful and perpetually blocked nasal cavity for the next month after. The stuff is so stupidly addictive. We'll never take it again because that experience was so miserable. Alcohol dependency. People only think being a full-blown alcoholic is an issue. The millions who can't go a day without booze yet are functional, and whose lives would be 10 times better without it, are the real issue. Social media, gaming, and attention addiction. So when I tell people I stayed up till 4 a.m. mindlessly browsing Reddit and YouTube, especially if I had far more important things to do and was very tired, they look bewildered and ask why I didn't simply stop. After all, I wasn't really engaged in what I was viewing. But it's not a matter of being actually interested, it's about continually getting that hit of dopamine, and it is ridiculously hard to break away, especially when a looming pile of tasks is building up due to procrastination. And anytime you stop aimlessly scrolling, you spiral into feeling overwhelmed and guilty about everything you didn't do. Recently, alcohol. You can be slamming back a six-pack every day after work, wine mom drinking out of a flask at soccer games and baby showers, 10 a.m. Sunday mimosas, and no one bats an eye as long as you're functioning and you turn it into a joke. Unless you're pissing yourself, drooling in a corner at 8 a.m. every morning, no one even thinks alcoholism. Weed dependency is real, but people will swear to you up and down it's not a problem because it's natural. I have this acquaintance that smokes weed every moment of every day because otherwise she has panic attacks. She views weed as some miracle drug, but it hasn't seemed to dawn on her that her panic attacks only started when she started smoking weed regularly. She's so high all the time that when she's not, she can no longer cope with what used to be perfectly normal and has a panic attack. I am all for decriminalizing it. I am all for smoking it recreationally. But dude, if you can't go to your job or go to the fucking grocery store without having to get high first, then I'm sorry, there is a problem here. This will sound weird, but winning. People nowadays need to feel like they are the victors of everything. If someone has an opinion that differs from yours that is not okay, you need to convince them they're wrong and you're right. I saw nobody say this, so I am gonna say it. Sadness. It might seem like a weird thing, but a lot of people are addicted to making themselves sad or making themselves feel pain. Caffeine. Mainly in the form of coffee, if it's energy drinks, it's suddenly much more of an issue. But people take pride in not functioning without their morning coffee. The amount of shirts, cups, and home decor saying stuff like, don't talk to me before my coffee, or but first coffee baffles me. If you can't function without it, you're addicted, Helen. Video games. I used to live with a guy who spent all his free time playing video games. Multiple games in the thousands of hours realm. From the second he got home, he timed his dinner, usually frozen pizza, to the second so he wouldn't have to be away from his computer long. He got fired from his job, said he needed a month to get to know himself and what he really wanted to do, whatever, right? Well, it turns out that looked like staying inside our apartment, continuously 4 to 5 days in a row, only leaving for groceries. Get up at 9, play video games until 10 or 11 PM, a month turned to 3, then pushed to 6, then pushed to a year, living on all the savings he had. Our lease was ending, we told him he needed to get a job to have income verification for his next place. He laughed at us, said a bank statement was fine. Didn't bother to go see the places he applied at in person that would take him away from his video games, got rejected 14 times before he finally came to reality that he needed a job. I was in a pinch, inflation had just blown up our city's already high rental market, and I had been considering moving back in with my parents to wait it out. Ended up taking pity and let him know I'd be willing to go in on a 2-bedroom with him so I could avoid that reality. He took the offer, but days later he had told a childhood friend that he had been getting turned away unfairly by renters for unknown reasons. The guy was nice enough to take pity on him, offered his guest bedroom for 3 months, and asked for just $200 to help cover utilities. He took it. And you'd think with that gesture, getting a job would be his number one priority, right? Nope. 6 months of living with him later, they asked him to move out because he had not found a job in that time, but rather played video games. He pulled on the heartstrings of one of my former roommates and ended up getting a job 1 year and 7 months after being fired. His favorite thing about it? He can WFH full-time, copying and pasting content for websites. So he moved into the cheapest apartment he could find, once again without looking in person, and invited us over to gloat over cheap rent. This apartment is in one of the worst places in our metro area, the sort of place you'd normally avoid stopping at from outward appearances, and somewhere you wouldn't want to be outside after dark. We went inside and the only thing that was really set up was, you guessed it, his computer. It's tragic to watch, I've stated my concern several times, but he ignores it, and my friend group would rather avoid having a sensitive conversation like that, no matter how important it is. He's a good guy that needs help, but he doesn't want to entertain that reality, so I just have to watch the years tick by with no change. Not subscribing to this channel is an addiction because I know you want more content. So do yourself a favor right now and drop a like, subscribe to this channel, and go ahead and turn on post notifications because we're going to be doing multiple uploads per week for new content.